They came in the night, swift and deadly. No one expected it. Man had suffered the drudges as a nuisance too long to see them as a true danger. But now, with unseen forces leading them, they overwhelmed Cragstone's defenses. The humans fought valiantly, Tumarok and Lugian allies at their side. But the enemy proved too many. By dawn, all that remained were ashes and blood. Now, after so many years, hope has rekindled near Cragstone's grave. The drudges remain ever a threat, their days as a mere annoyance forgotten. Yet those who would protect new Cragstone have found a key to victory. Glyphs, enchanted stones that will open vaults holding secrets long forgotten. Perhaps what lies within these vaults will prove our salvation, the means to take back what has been lost. Time and the bravery of those who dare to enter will tell. To the Tumarok, the land is sacred. It is the source of their power, but it is also much more. A living thing, home to the spirits with whom they commune. Every tree, every stone, every pool speaks to them. It is only fitting that they chose the purest places to bury their own dead. For the Tumarok, there is no greater honor than to return to the land. Their burial grounds were sacrosanct and tempting targets for corruption. In time, a new magic came to the land. A magic not of creation and life, but of blight and decay. Jungles turned dark and twisted, swamplands fetid and grim. The spirits wailed in agony, their cries echoing among the tormented trees. The Baroon won a subtle war. Not of steel and flame, but of pestilence and rot. But by sword or spell, the end is the same. The Tumarok's sacred grounds have fallen. As long as the Baroon remain, the land will go on weeping. The Gurog appeared after the world shattered. For decades they lived beside the Lugians, bound by a fragile truce. But everything fragile breaks in time. The Lugians fought bravely, meeting the enemy on the slopes near Linvak Tukal. With a roar of steel, the final battle joined. Before, the Lugians would have carried the day. But the Gurog had changed. They were mightier than before, twisted with dark power. The battle lasted 5 long days. But in the end, the enemy prevailed. Lugian blood poured down the mountainside. The Lugian chanters still sing of their defeat, their songs filled with questions. How could Linvak's glory crumble so quickly? Where did the Gurog's new strength come from? And who were the cloaked figures who laughed about the battlefield when the massacre was done?
He was the one who watched over us when the whole world seemed our enemy. He guided us, protected us. He was Asheron, the last of the Empyrean, whose magic called us here. Through the Golden Age, he remained apart from the world, so we might follow our own path. But when darkness threatened to swallow the land, he was there. He gave himself for the good of all. Asheron was no god. We do not bow to him, but we do honor his memory. We are the Order of Dareth, sworn to follow Asheron's ideals. Compassion, justice, righteousness. This is our creed. In his name, we shall rebuild the world.
Folk remember the dark times, when destruction roamed the land. They think of war, death, torment. They blame those of us who walk in shadow, call us evil. But we are not. We were deceived by the one who ruled us. To understand us, you must first understand him. Hope Slayer, they called him. Baelzeron, the Fallen Lord. He craved power and gave himself to chaos. His obsession nearly destroyed the world. The Shadow Kingdom's path runs along the sword's edge. On one side, untold strength. On the other, madness. The Hope Slayer strayed and fell. Look on his face and swear, I will not follow.
Strange, brimming with chaos. We live borrowed lives tossed by random winds. Blood and bedlam dog your steps.
You sleep with breath held, awaiting death from the dark.
Such abhorrence is intolerable. Order must be imposed. The world cannot remain this way.
You will serve order or be swept aside. It is your choice.
But is it not better to sleep without the fear of waking with claws upon your throat?
Winter came early to Derekhost, and did not leave. The halls of the palace sparkled with frost. One day, ships appeared from the east, gliding into the harbor. The women aboard these ships were strange, tall with eyes of marble green. They came to the palace, telling of their home, an island lost to darkness. The king had a son, Geraint, a sickly boy who coughed blood. The women offered him relief. If his mind was strong, he could have eternal life. Geraint traveled to the Witch's Island, and there he learned the truth. To give up death, one must forsake life as well. So Geraint became undead, the firstborn.